government, but the church still held together. 10 years ago, Resurrection Community Church started out on a shoestring budget and prayer. And over that time, it has been held together by an inconvenient love that can be seen from a hill called Calvary, where the horizontal cross beam of human imperfection intersects with the vertical cross beam of God's perfection. So what has this all to do with Advent? Paul is writing to an early church community about Advent of Christ in their world. What did the coming of Christ mean to them? Part of the struggle for the early church was the growing impatience with Christ's impending return. They thought it would be weeks, months, years before Christ returned. They had no idea it would be several millennia. Some 2,000 years later, while we may not be impatient because of Christ's imminent return, we do become frustrated by the unpredictability of life. And it is this unpredictability that can cause us to lose focus on the Advent. Because the power of Advent lies in the anticipation of hope, the anticipation of joy, the anticipation of peace, as well as the anticipation of love. Advent is not merely the next 4 weeks, but it marks the beginning of the Christian calendar in which we commit ourselves through the next year to be living examples of hope, joy, peace, and love, which is the embodiment of Christ. If you are not willing to make that commitment, you're wasting your time. More importantly, you're wasting God's time. Just as Paul was telling the church at Thessalonica, God is also reminding the church of Resurrection Community that we must commit to the simplistic but difficult teachings of Christ. What about this particular season of Advent? The one thing it does do is to remind us that we must live out these things these next 4 weeks for the entire year. There is no way you and I can live out the Advent throughout the year if we are not intentional and conscious about making that commitment. If we are not conscious about Advent when stuff happens, we will become frustrated and disillusioned. Moreover, if we're not intentional about living out the Advent beyond the next 4 weeks, our faith won't amount to much, and we might as well call ourselves the Resurrection Community Society. Because we'll be just like the Moose Lodge and the Elks Club. It won't matter. We'll get some secret handshake and wear some funny little hats. It won't matter. But as Paul states in verse 12, may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we abound in love for you. We cannot abound in love for 4 weeks and believe we have fulfilled the Advent commitment. Love is the difficult determination to see value in people. We both know that it's inconvenient, too often it's unappreciated, but love is what gets each and every one of us closer to God. If we have the courage to abound in love, Jesus says, by this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you have love for one another. If we are to abound in love, we must be prepared to give. There is a good chance you will confront someone during the Christmas season who will affront you with something less than love. Probably while the only way to get a Christmas gift. But the question is, how will we respond? The challenge for followers of Jesus is to abound in love when you're clobbered with hate, to abound in love when you're jabbed with jealousy, to abound in love when you're shoved by pettiness, abound in love when you're floored by dishonesty, to abound in love when you're plowed over by prejudice. The late Professor Leo Seliger gave a good description many years ago about the proper attitude we ought to have for Advent. He writes, people are unreasonable, illogical, and self-centered. Love them anyway. If you do good, people will accuse you of selfish, ulterior motives. Do good anyway. If you're successful, you'll win friends and true enemies. Succeed anyway. The good you do today will be forgotten tomorrow. Do good anyway. Honesty and frankness will make you vulnerable. Be honest and frank anyway. When you spend years building may be destroyed overnight, build anyway. People really need help the most may attack you if you help them. Help people anyway. Give the world the best you have and you'll get kicked in the teeth. Give the world the best you have anyway. The thing that we must remember on this spiritual journey, there are no guarantees. Our faith doesn't come with a warranty. All we know is that when they knock against the ropes, come out slowly. When they knock you down, get up. When they laugh at you, keep smiling. When they talk about you, keep loving. And when they kill you, just rise again.
Amen.
Let us accept Advent challenge with courage that is fortified by Jesus' love and God's grace over the next 4 weeks, not just for the next 4 weeks, but throughout the new year that is to come. Now, where we rest.